G'day students and welcome to today's lockdown lesson for Sales Management in 5. In hierdie gedeelte van hoofstuk 11 gaan ons kyk na die tegnieke wat verkoopspersone kan gebruik om hierdie objections wat hulle moontlik kan kry te oorkom. Now in the previous video we said that objections are not always a rejection. It's not that they just don't want to buy the product necessarily. Dit kan baie ander redes ook wees. Dit kan fisiese rede wees, dit kan sielkundige redes wees. Sometimes they just don't have enough knowledge or they don't have enough money. So ons moet regtig die saak baie interessant benader om seker te maak dat ons mooi verstaan hoekom die persoon nie die produk wil koop nie, hoekom hulle verskonings maak before we can choose a technique to overcome it. Now these techniques you can find on page 94, 95 in your textbook, and in this video we are just going to briefly look at these techniques before moving on to the next module. Okay, so kom ons kyk bietjie na wat is hierdie tegnieke. Die eerste tegniek is om baie meer spesifieke vrae te vra. Sê maar hoekom? Hoekom voel jy so oor die produk? Wat is spesifiek die probleem? Okay, because as a salesperson, you must try to understand why the person does not want to buy the product. Okay, so jy kan nie net op jou rug gaan lê en sê, ach, okay, dis okay, moenie worry nie. As a salesperson, if you want to be successful, if you want to make that sale, you have to understand why. So vra die vraag, hoekom en wat? Then you must convert the objection into an advantage. So as die persoon sê, is my so 'n bietjie duur, ek kan nie die product koop nie. Hoe gaan jy as verkoopspersoon sê, alright, ja, dit is bietjie duur, maar, okay, how are you going to change that objection into a benefit or an advantage for the customer to persuade them to purchase the product? The third technique is to provide them with proof. So as jy agterkom, hierdie persoon is bietjie huiwerig, want hulle glo nie regtig al die claims wat jy maak nie, it's very important then to provide them with proof and with evidence as far as possible to provide credibility, not only for you as a salesperson or the business, but also for the product. Dan moet jy ook natuurlik sê, agree and qualify. Ja, ek stem met jou saam, maar. Okay, so ja, ek hoor wat jy sê, maar. So that's a very interesting technique to use because it shows empathy towards the prospective buyer. To say, ja, ek verstaan wat jy sê, ja, ek hoor wat jy sê, maar. So you always try to take that objection and turn it into something positive and to continue persuading them to purchase the product. Then you can also provide them with more information. Gee vir hulle brosjure, wys vir hulle video, sê hoor hier kom, ek gaan verduidelik vir jou 'n bietjie meer. Het jy 'n bietjie meer tyd? Kom dan kyk of ek vir jou meer inligting kan gee. Try and educate them, because remember one of the objections is they just don't have enough information. So probeer vir hulle meer as moontlik inligting gee. You can also overcome with agreement. They say there are times when there is no answer to an objection and the salesperson knows this. Your product may be better in most cases than your competitors, but may not be able to compete with the competitor's product on a few less important points. By agreeing, it does not mean you agree that the prospect is right. It simply means that you understand his point of view. So baie kere is dit sê, ach, ek hoor wat jy sê, dit is heeltemal so. Okay. Ja, my produk is dalk presies dieselfde as aan die een sin. Ja, my prys is dalk 'n bietjie meer. Dalk kan ek vir jou op 'n ander manier probeer oor het my produk te koop. Okay, so sometimes you have to agree and overcome with the customer. You can also use a technique to compare products and services. Jy kan jou produk met 'n mededingersin vergelyk en sê, "Oor hier is my produk, hier is daai produk, kom ons vergelyk." Compare with the customer, so you can also get their insight as well. Daarna kan jy ook sê, they say show the prospect what delay could cost. So jy sê vir hulle, okay, die produk kos nou R1000, maar met die huidige situasie in ons land, met invoere wat begin duurder raak, met die rand-dollar wisselkoers, gaan die toekomstige invoere van die produk baie duurder wees. An example, I wanted to buy a sewing machine. Okay, so ek is nou op hierdie nuwe gier, ek wil 'n naaldwerkmasjien koop. En ek kontak toe 'n vrou en die vrou sê vir my, sy het hierdie baie oulike masjien, hy kos nou by haar R3200 vir die masjien en sy het hom beskikbaar. And if I want to, I can come get it. And obviously, my objection is, she was baie geld, ek het dit nie nou nie, I cannot buy the product right now. Okay, yes, I'm still interested, but I don't have the money right now. So it's not only the price, it's just also the availability of money. Toe sê sy vir my, ja, maar jy moet onthou, hierdie produkte word ingevoer en met die rand-dollar wisselkoers en met die huidige situasie van invoer in ons land, it will be more expensive in, if you buy it only in a few months time. Okay, so dis 'n baie effektiewe tegniek to persuade the customer to buy right now. In my geval het dit ongelukkig nie gewerk nie, because I know that as jy nie geld het nie, het jy nie geld nie. and you don't always want to make debt to buy these types of products, maar vir baie ander kliënte kan dit moontlik die laaste dingetjie wees om hulle te oorreed om 'n produk dadelik te koop. You can also relate the product to the prospect's buying motive. So jy kan sê, "Alright, dit is jou motief. Dis hoekom jy die produk koop." Okay, nou dit is hoe my produk in daardie prentjie van jou kan pas. And then lastly, try to limit objections or to anticipate objections. In ander woorde, jy moet vooraf begin dink as 'n verkoopspersoon, wat is die moontlike objections wat ons kan kry? And how can I answer that during my sales presentation before the actual objection is actually given? So jy as verkoopspersoon kan voor die tyd al sê, hoorie, in my aanbieding, ja, ek weet julle gaan dalk nou sê die pryse is bietjie duur, maar kom ek gee vir julle die voordele. So selfs terwyl jy jou aanbieding doen, kan jy seker maak dat jy baie van hierdie objections aanspreek. Okay. So that is the end of module 11. In die volgende video gaan ons bietjie kyk na module 12. Maar tot dan, bye.